हेलो सर,
या
आई विल स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम।
या
ओके, सो आई विल गिव यू स्मॉल इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट गावस्कर सर। ओके, सो गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लिसन द वेबिनार ऑन मेटावर्स यूजिंग अलीबाबा क्लाउड। दिस इज अ लेटेस्ट ट्रेंड इन क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज। A lot of boom is there in the metaverse technology with web activity. So today our guest is Gavaskar, from Multicloud Deputy Director, Delivery Director at Multicloud for you, Kutleya.com. And he received his BTech IT from Anna University in the year 2005, and also studied Masters in Network and Internet Engineering from Carnegie University in 2009. He has around 10 years of experience in teaching, particularly in the computer science departments, and more than 14 years of experience in the IT related fields. And he received a most prestigious award, international award, MEP, Most Valuable Professional Award from Alibaba Cloud in 2021. And he has three associate level certificate with Microsoft Azure, and two professional certificate from DevOps, and also seven associate certificate from Alibaba Cloud. He has won innovation awards in Alibaba Cloud during the Global AI Challenge in 2021, and more than 500 teams participated on this. And also he received a weather prediction innovation award in Alibaba Cloud. He is there with a lot of developer circles and social medias and other related activities. He is very popular in Alibaba Cloud technologies and other things. Okay. So, with this small introduction about the Gavaskar, I like to.
For giving introduction about myself, let me share the slides first. Welcome all the participants for Metaverse Universe or Metaverse using Alibaba Cloud. So we are going to see how we can leverage Alibaba Cloud to the latest technology, that is Metaverse. And I like to thank AMC College of Engineering for calling us Multicloud for you for conducting this technical session or nano session or the webinar. I like to thank Dr. Girish C, Principal IMC Engineering College, Dr. K. Mallikarjuna Babu, the Director IMC College of Engineering, and HOD of Mechanical Engineering Department, Dr. Sangala Kulu. And I like to thank Dr. Coordinators, the coordinators for this nano sessions, that is technical sessions, that is Dr. A. Namudal and Professor Rudra and Professor Bhaira Reddy. And I have to especially thank my colleagues or my fellow MED, that is Dr. Amudan, for personally inviting me to handle this session. And this session is we are delivering through Multicloud for you, and we are going to get a certification directly from Alibaba Cloud. So that's all the introduction part. Now let me move to introduce about my Palgadi Dr. Amudan, my fellow MEP. Dr. Amudan, introduce more about me again. Okay, I work as assistant professor in St. Xavier's Catholic College of Engineering. I am hailing from South India, that is Nagarkoil. I have 14 plus years of IT experience working across leading organizations in the industries. Now currently I am working as a delivery director in Multicloud for you. And Afruthaya.com, which is a learning platform through which you can learn some nano sessions or technical sessions by logging to www.afruthaya.com. I am MEP at Alibaba Cloud, and I have hundreds of certifications from Alibaba Cloud, and I have three associate level certifications from Microsoft Azure, and seven ACA certifications from Alibaba Cloud, and two ACP level certifications from Alibaba Cloud, and I won many global challenges. More than 2,500 teams participated in Alibaba Cloud. That's all about a short introduction about me. And you can see more about me in the given LinkedIn profile. And you can communicate to me at gavaskar.x@multicloudforyou.com. So now moving to who we are and what we are. Who we are? That's we are. We have 100,000 of strong community of technologists spread all over the world, and we multi cloud for you and Jupyter.com deal with multi cloud strategy, multi cloud, hybrid cloud, circuit breaker cloud, migration, enterprise cloud, data strategy, data security, and of course we deal with the metaverses also. That's metaverse deals with the artificial intelligence, data science, blockchain, and stream engineering, and we deal with the data science and AI, scientific computing, enterprise data science framework, and machine learning, auto ML, cloud ML, mathematical optimization, deep learning, and we multi cloud also deal with the technical solutions and live sessions on blockchain technology, smart contracts, and blockchain security, blockchain implementation, and we also deal with extreme engineering. That's all about a short introduction about multi cloud for you. And what is Jupyter? Jupyter is an education platform for a learning platform through which you can learn some nano sessions or technical sessions related to blockchain, metaverse, or engineering. Okay, so we have our visibility in all over the world. We are expanding northeast, Middle East, and North America, South America. We have our strong technology community all over the world. So now moving to Jupyter.com. So we in Jupyter is stands for Fifth Industrial Revolution. We are mainly focusing on nano sessions to develop T-shaped individual. That's so that the passage from Fourth Industrial Revolution to the Fifth Industrial Revolution can be made easy. So now these are the different peoples who has given who are associated with our platform directly and indirectly. I hope everyone may be knowing about Bill Inman, is a father of data warehouse. Has given a session in our platform, that is www.jupyter.com. And I hope everyone know about this person. This is Bart Pudi. He's a principal scientist from Microsoft. He has given a session on SQL Ledger database. That's it's another database which is used for implementing blockchain applications. And I hope everyone may be knowing about Anna Hoffman. She's a well-known person from my Microsoft Azure team. She has given a session in our platform. And this is Dan Sullivan. He's a well-known educationist in Udemy platform. Has given a talk on Google data platform in our Jupyter.com last week. And these are the different pupils who has given a talk or who was directly or indirectly associated with our platform on multi-cloud for you. Now, moving to our partnership with the Alibaba Cloud. We are the academic and training partner of Alibaba Cloud, and you can see more about us in the given URL, that is uu.alibabacloud.com/training-partner. Now, we have done certain certifications with Alibaba Cloud in association with Alibaba Cloud. These are the few certifications which you can get it once you log into www.jupyter.com. Object storage services and use cases. This is one of the certifications we have done in association certification plus course. This is an academic course which we have done in association with Alibaba Cloud. And Terraform Canson course with DevOps is another course along with the certification we have done with Alibaba Cloud. And this is another courses which is done in association with Alibaba Cloud. And of course, today's session, that's today's nano session or technical session, we are going to provide a certificate directly from Alibaba Cloud. That's Metaverse with Alibaba Cloud. You are going to get the certificate directly from the Alibaba Cloud once you may create your account, and once you completed the pieces, 15 question pieces are there, and the pieces are will be related to the session which I am going to handle. Okay. So this is a link which you can utilize for getting the certificate for this particular session. So now moving to the agenda. Now first we are going to see what is cloud computing. Since we are going to see how Metaverse is leveraged by Alibaba Cloud or utilized by Alibaba Cloud. So we are going to have a short introduction. I hope that most of the students may be from mechanical department, since the nano session or technical session is hosted by mechanical engineering department. I hope that most of the people may be from mechanical department. So I am going to have a short introduction on what is cloud computing and what are the advantages of cloud computing and why the organization. Nowadays, no, most of the organizations are moving to cloud. I am going to explain about that. Then I am going to have a short introduction on what is Alibaba Cloud and what are the global infrastructures provided by Alibaba Cloud and what is the advantages of Alibaba Cloud. I am going to explain. Then we are going to see about introduction to metaverse. This is our topic today. So I have categorized it. I am going to explain with a video for you what is metaverse. So metaverse, no, I hope that no, you may, if you are a 90s kids, you may be knowing about some fiction videos and comic videos will be there. That will be, no, 20 years back, no, 20 years back, some videos will be there. But we may be thinking that whether this will happen or not. But it has happened after 20 years. Okay, so I am going to display a video from a movie. That's, I hope everyone may be knowing about this movie. Yeah, in that movie, no, one song will be there. No, one song will be there. That I am going to play that song over it. That I am going to tell us what. So old us. That's happened. This particular movie is released in the year 1998. That is 20 years back. Now you see that technology is coming into existence. That's after 20 years that technology is coming to existence. So now I am going to tell that as metaverse. So old, no, it is, I am telling that as old verse. And now the new thing I am going to tell as new verse, that's, I am going to display a video based on the metaverse, what happening today. And I hope that, no, everyone may be knowing about one news, that is the first ever marriage on metaverse is going to happen in India. Okay, but two couples are going to be married through metaverse in India, which is going to happen in the near future. That video also I'm going to display for you. And how the workplace can be changed. Now, current workplace, you know that you may be sitting in your individual room and you may attend to that. And how we can make it more collaborative and more, and by using metaverse technology, we are going to see that using a small video released by Meta, that is Facebook. And we are going to see the pillars of metaverse, that is holographic construction. What is holographic construction? That's how to create a holographic image using people's and entities present in the real world. We are going to see. And how to simulate the people and entities which is present in the real world. That is in the physical world, you may see some object as well as your people should be there. We have to simulate that. We have to simulate that and we have to construct that. That we will tell us holographic construction and simulation. And then what we have to do is that once we have constructed the holographic, that's 3D image, we can tell now. 3D image of holographic construction is made or simulation is made. We have to apply virtual reality to that. That's virtual reality integration. We have to do the transformation. That is, we have to control the virtual world with the real world and real world with the virtual world. That we have to do. We have to have an interaction between the virtual world and the real world or physical world. That's the other aspect. Then, of course, today's topic it is what? Metaverse with Alibaba Cloud. Now, if you are interested with Alibaba Cloud or if you are interested, if you want to do some exploration in Alibaba Cloud, I'm going to explain you set of technologies which can be used in Alibaba Cloud for creating metaverse applications. Set of remote rendering, we are going to see how we can achieve remote rendering. And you see here, for each and every technology, set of products are there in Alibaba Cloud. I am going to explain each and every product. And it is not possible to explain whole functionality of the product. So in certain places, I will be explaining just the product name alone. And then we are going to see about data analytics. Of course, no data, without data analytics, it is not possible possible to have and better metaverse. It is not possible. Then Internet of Things, IoT is a key player. Here and blockchain, it is another technology which is going to deal with the metaverse. And you see, if any technology is there, network solution should be there, proper network solution should be there. And so that only nowadays, Windows is moving to 5G technology. So, if you are going for a metaverse technology, we are going to have rendering, 3D rendering is there, and more number of bandwidth is required for displaying the rendering. So that now we are going to see what are the global network solutions provided by Alibaba Cloud for metaverse applications. And finally, we are going to see about container technology. That's Alibaba Cloud container service for Kubernetes. So nowadays, I hope that this is a new technology for mechanical products. Nowadays, we are not going to use a new set of surveys, set of physical machines or virtual machines for deploying our applications. We are going for a container technology. We are going to create some container, and it is a Docker container. We tell that is a Docker container, and we are going to control that by using Kubernetes. So we are going to see how to, what are the different types of Kubernetes supported by Alibaba Cloud. So this is a short introduction short agenda. I hope that now I can complete within 1 hour, but it is a vast topic. I hope that now I can give a small spark on you. I can create a spark on you on what is Metaverse. I cannot cover most of the concept again. I cannot, this is a booming technology. I cannot show some demo to you. Yes, it is not possible, but I can show some demo in Alibaba Cloud. But I do the time concern, I cannot do that also. Okay. So, and finally, the time is there, no key takeaways. Our key takeaways will be, I am going to demonstrate how to create a free Alibaba Cloud account to account. Then we are going to have a certifications from directly from Alibaba Cloud. That is, we are going to have a cloud of certifications from Alibaba Cloud, and we are going to get a participation certificate from multi-cloud for all the party participants. So now moving to cloud. Okay. Nowadays, I've already mentioned that most of the organization is moving to the cloud. The reason is now it is a total cost of ownership. Or if you want to invest on more on the business, that the investment cost can be reduced. So this is the reason why the most of the organization is moving to cloud. Now you see, what is cloud? Now everyone wants to know about cloud. You see, if you are in a day-to-day life, you may be placing cloud, but you don't know the term cloud. That's the thing. That's computer science students may know that. But how the data, where the data is stored, your data, whether it's in a mobile or day-to-day life, whatever things you are doing, the data will be stored in the cloud. That's cloud servers, the data will be stored. So now what is cloud? It is a delivery of on-demand resources. The resource may be service, databases, storage, platform, infrastructure, or application. Anything you are going to get it as a demand, on demand. You are getting some services through internet. We will tell you that as a cloud computer. Now moving to certain advantages of cloud. So first advantage of cloud is reliability. So before using some services in the cloud, now you will provide a service level agreement. You will sign a service level agreement with the cloud service provider. So that whatever requirements or what are specifications made in the cloud in the service level agreement will be provided by the cloud service provider. There will not be downtime, there will not resource outages. Now you see here, if there is a downtime or resource outages, you will be if it is violating the service level agreement, the cloud service provider will provide a compensation for it. Why I am telling is now recently, many of them may appear that AWS cloud services, certain service outages are there. Okay. So now we cannot tell that cloud is 100% there, so there is no downtime or there is no resource outages. But resource outages and downtime will be there. But if certain things are there, it will be equally compensated for. And another important feature, if you have to know the scalability, this is an important feature why organizations or enterprises move into cloud. We can scale the resource, that is vertically and horizontally. This is the important point you have to know here. So we can do horizontal scaling, that is horizontal scaling can be done by increasing the virtual machines. We can increase the machine. For initially, if you have 10 machines, we are purchasing 10 machines, virtual machines. No, we then we have virtual machines, similar to virtual reality and augmented reality. We will not tell us a physical machine. So some software will be installed in the system, and through that software, you may be accessing that particular machine. We tell that as a virtual machine. So we can increase the size of the virtual machine. That's we tell us horizontal scaling. And vertical scaling, you can increase the capacity of the virtual machine. That's what you can increase the RAM size, CPU of the virtual machine, you can do that. So both vertical scaling and horizontal scaling is possible by using Alibaba Cloud or any cloud service provider. Now, another advantage is elasticity. So we can increase the resources based on the demand. You think that you have peak workload is there between every day between 1 p.m. and 2 p.m. So what you can do is you can allocate more number of virtual machines or more number of resources at the particular time. And once this peak workload is over, you can scale out the resources. That is, scale, you can release the resources. That we tell us elasticity. So this is not possible when you are going for an on-premise environment. Once you purchase 100 machines, each and every time at the end, at 24/7, 20, this particular machines will be running. Okay. Here we can based on the demand, we can increase or decrease the resources or decrease the virtual machines. Another important feature which I like more is agility. So you can deploy your application or you can create your application quickly. So you did not want to bother about infrastructure or you did not want to bother about the software. You just, by using a few mouse clicks, you can deploy your application in the cloud. So I can have to tell one example for you. Introducing some concept related to computer science and engineering. Yes. Okay, now if you want to create a PHP application, you think that you have to create a PHP applications. So now we need a set of servers, you know, SAM servers, SAM server, we can install 4 to 5 softwares. So it will take some time if you are doing your machine. But you see, by using a single mouse click, in cloud, you can deploy an application. It is possible. You can search the service, marketplace, different services for the person or different products or person. Just you can purchase the product, and by using a mouse click, you can deploy your application. You did not want to install the software, or you did not want to provision your hardware or anything. You can do that. So that is the another important feature. Why organization or why the institutions or enterprises are moving to cloud. And another advantage is geo distribution. Okay, you can deploy your application in any other region. So now you have to know what is the region. Region is a physical location at which the infrastructure, the data center is present. So each and every cloud service provider will now set up data centers present in different regions in all over the world. Now if you consider Alibaba Cloud, it has data center in Pune. And if you see the AWS, it has data center in Hyderabad, Chennai. Now Azure will have data center in Chennai also. So similarly, you can deploy your application anywhere. Now you see that more number of use cases present in India. You can deploy your application in India. Reason is what? You can provide the application with low latency for your users in India. Since more number of proximity users present in India, you can deploy your application in India data center. So this is another feature. No, you have to know. We can create your application and you can deploy your application in any of the regions present in the world. So now moving to introduction to Alibaba Cloud. So I hope everyone may be knowing about different set of cloud service provider. Now Alibaba Cloud is the cloud computing company and it is a subsidiary of Alibaba Group. Alibaba Group is one of the famous e-commerce company in China. And it is founded in the year 2009. And it provides cloud computing services to the online business and its own e-commerce ecosystem, that is AlibabaCloud.com. Its international operations are registered and its headquarters is in Singapore. And it is ranked number 3 in value and first in Southeast Asia. And another thing you have to know here is, if you want to know the power of Alibaba Cloud, you have to know one festival, that is Double Down Festival. Before explaining about Double Down Festival, I will explain similar kind of scenario which is happening in our country also. So I hope that everyone may know about Big Billion Day or Flash Sale of Flipkart. So in Big Billion Day, particular offers, more number of offers will be provided by e-commerce providers during certain time, that is 12 a.m. to 1 p.m. or 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. like that. During peak or during 1 hour, certain offers will be provided by e-commerce suppliers. So what people will do? More number of people will access that particular site at the same time. That is, lakhs of readers will be received at a single second. So this has to be processed more efficiently and more accurately. We have to do that. Similarly, this is Double Down Festival is one kind of festival which is hosted in China. And you see the scenarios achieved during this particular Double Down Festival. Total gross merchandise value which is achieved is 540.3 billion of transactions is done in the single day. I'm talking about the single day, that's Double Down. That is, this will be happened during 11/11/2021 all the year. No, the reason it happens in 11/11/2021. And you see all the core business, that's another thing that know here. All the core business is running in container cloud native technology, that's latest technology. So you see more than 1 billion containers are running at the same time to process the request. So 1 million, you see, if 1 million container is running, how the processing technology should be there and how the networking technology should be there. You see, it is not, I'm telling about 1 million physical devices, 1 million virtual containers are running, virtual devices are running, and it is coordinated for achieving this particular festival request. And you see, another advantage, most of the data centers are equipped with the green, reduced carbon dioxide emission, and green technology is used. Okay, data center release 26,000 tons of carbon dioxide. And you see, for delivering the items, 350 unmanaged robots are used. And you see, the daily, each and every day, 50,000 parcels were delivered each and every day. And you see, this is a message, no, which is processed per second. You see, 669900 messages were processed in a second. You see the processing capability and what kind of security mechanism, what kind of storage mechanism, what kind of processing mechanism they have to adopt for this particular things has to happen. Okay. So now moving to the global infrastructure of Alibaba Cloud or global infrastructure of any cloud service provider. You have to know two things. That's region and availability. So now what is a region? Region is a physical location at which the infrastructure or data center is present, at which the particular cloud service provider's infrastructure is present. That is, set of servers will be there, data centers will be there, all this is present. We will tell us region. And you see what is zone, availability zone, that you know. So it is an individual data centers which is present inside the region. Separate data center is present inside the region, and each data center will be separated by individual power supply, individual backup, everything will be there. So that if one availability zone is down, another one will be alive at the same time. So that we will tell us availability zone. This you have to know clear. Okay. As any cloud service providers, regions will be there and availability zones will be there. In case Alibaba Cloud, we have a region in Mumbai and three availability zones are there. Zone A, Zone B, and Zone C. Three availability zones there. If one zone spot down, another zone will wake up. Okay. And again, 2,800 plus content delivery node is there, and it is available in 200 plus countries. So now moving to what is metaverse. So here, as I mentioned earlier, but now first of all, I am going to do is I am going to tell is I am going to explain about old verse. That's the name which I have given for you. No, it is not. You cannot find any. This is not a meaning old verse because I have given the name as old verse. When Amudan told me the term metaverse, so just I surfed in the net and I find. My got stuck with one of the video which I watched. I hope that all the 90s kids know, maybe watch this particular movie Jeans. Okay, so Jeans movie, one song is there. No, in that song actually Aishwarya Rai will be playing a dual role in that movie, and Prasanth will also playing a dual role in the movie. But actually no, Prasanth, the actual twins, they are twins, but here no, that the dual role played by Aishwarya Rai is not, they are not actual kings. But there is a situation that they have to perform a dance in a stage, jointly, they have to perform a dance. How to do that? It is done through that service part. Now we are telling us metaverse, the old, no, in we will tell this as graphics. No? They have done some graphics in that particular movie, and they have made both the actors, both Aishwarya Khan, that's both twins. No, it's actually true. Only one Aishwarya is there in that movie, but they have made them to act in the stage. So that's the thing I am telling as old verse that happens in the year 1998. Okay, at that time, no, you see this movie, most of the people will watch this movie. The reason behind this is, no, sir, I am a 1996. We will watch this movie for seeing this animation. So some people know, those are the people know aged about 30, they will watch this movie, no, 7 Wonders of the World is displayed in this movie, one of the song. For that they will watch. Okay. So now I will display. This is the movie detail. This is directed by Sandar. And this is released in the year 24 April 1990. And this is released in Tamil and so I hope that in most of the languages displayed. So now this is, I'm going to tell this as old bus. Now you see, I will display this movie. And you display this video and you see what is happening over there. Now you have to relate this with the what are the concepts I am going to explain to you. So you will better understand what is metaverse. So now I will I will play the video. Yeah, so I hope that. Now, no, this is the actual Aishwarya Rai. No, Aishwarya Rai is a dual role played by both Aishwarya Rai and Prasanth. No, Prasanth, they are actually twins. No, actually they are twins. But you see here, this is not actual twins, but they are going to dance the same stage by using what? Now we are telling this as a virtual reality in olden days. That's 20 years back, we will tell this as what? Animation or graphics, like that we will tell. The name is changed over here, okay? So now you have to know only here. So that person know, we will tell that as a real world. Okay, this is a real world, something happening over here. Now which you are projecting in the screen now, we will tell as a virtual world. Okay. So objects or entities which is present in the real world, which you are projecting to project in the virtual world. Okay, that's the thing we will tell as transformation. Virtual reality transformation. Okay, now if you understand the terms in this movie, no, what is happening in this movie, I hope that you will understand metaverse clearly. Okay. Yeah. Now this is a virtual world. We are something where we are displaying. No? This is a virtual world. And something which is physically done, that person is doing some action in the background, that is what we will tell us a physical world. Okay. So we have to map the specific to the entities and peoples and object which is present in the real world to the physical world to the real world and physical world to the real world. It is also to be done. Okay, that's the need tell us metaverse. Okay. Yeah. Now what I will do is I will skip the video. Now you can see this video in the YouTube. Okay. So it will take more time. So I will skip the video and I will play something in the last. Okay. So that it will be more interesting for you. So you see here. So what is happening? Yeah, that's all regarding that video. Now you see, when this movie came to the assistant home, we thought that this will not happen. That's the thing, we will be watching this in TVs or and that, there is no internet or that is not popular. The TV, we watch this video often. But we didn't think that this will come to be an assistant. But you see, after 20 years, it is coming to an assistant, okay? So here you see something, you know, that person is going to project using the projector. Now that kind of project, only project is there. Now here, now you have to know what is physical world and a real world. In this case, the particular person is the physical world. He is doing something that actually is displayed over here. Now what, in the metaverse, what we can do is, from the virtual world, we can control the physical world. That is also happening. That we can do that. That's the difference, no, from this movie. But you see, this is a picture. Similarly, you know, you can see many fiction movies. Actually, the metaverse technology is the extension of some fiction movies, which is happened in some English movies only, actually. That is going to be happen existence over now. Okay. So now this is the thing I told us, old metaverse, world verse. Okay. Now you see in latest. You see, let us know, this is the thing, you know, now it is a hot topic in social media. One of the couple from Tamil Nadu, now Tamil Nadu, they are going to have their marriage in using metaverse technology. Yes, so that what they are going to do is, they are going, this particular bride's father is not there. No, father has died when she was a small, yes, no, small, when she was 10 years or 15 years. So they are going to create his father. Okay, they are going to create a father using hologram technology, that is using metaverse, and this father is going to attend the marriage, and anyone from the world can join this marriage. Okay, that is the near future, it is going to happen in India, and first time it is going to happen first time in India. So just I will play this video for sorry, I told that her father last during the early days. No, it's not like that. Before, no, 1 month before. So now what they are going to do, that's thing you have to know clearly. They are going to virtually create their father. Okay, and this father is going to attend the marriage. Okay, that's the thing you have to do. Part of the country. This is the thing, no, Jenna's father, no, they are going to generate their father, no, using metaverse technology, and this particular father, this father is going to attend the marriage. Okay, that's the I hope the, no, you got a clear understanding about the metaverse by this video. So we are going to relate the physical world and the virtual world. Okay, we are going to relate that thing. You have to know clearly the objects or persons or any entities present in the physical world, you are going to relate to in the virtual world. And again, virtual to physical mapping can also be done. Physical to virtual mapping can also be done by using metaverse. Okay. So now I will display another video, how your workplace will be changed if you are using metaverse. So, yeah, now you see, this is a 1 minute video. You might watch this video. No, it is released by Facebook. So now you see how. I hope I don't did not want to explain this video. I hope you understand what is happening. Okay, this is the nothing but this is the extension of what we are doing now. Okay, we are doing virtually in individual room, you are sitting and doing that. You can create your environment virtually. And this is what physical world mapping and real world mapping will become over there. Which you can set the place and we can do that. Everything will be happening, you know. This seems to be we are doing in physical. The meeting will be physical, but it's happening in the real world, in the virtual. Okay. I hope you understand this. So in this videos, we saw old verse, what is happening, is using projector. Now how what is happening? Okay. So now you see. Yeah, now we are moving to actual metaverse. I hope I rushed up the session. So I have to complete by 10:15. Okay. So now you see what is metaverse? It's the next generation of internet. So it is based on virtual reality and augmented reality. Something virtual. What is virtual reality? Something is not present really, but virtually it is present. You see in this video, they are creating an environment, they are creating a meeting place virtually, but it is not physically, it is not present. Physically, somewhere it may be present. Okay, physically somewhere may be present, but they are creating virtually and they are having their meeting over there. Now, what are the things mapping we have to do? You see, digital world is mapped to the physical world. Digital is mapped to the physical world. Digital life and social life, the mapping, you see, metaverse concept connects people and objects in the real world to the reality, virtual world to the reality. What are the mappings we have to do is, digital economy we have to map to the real world economy. Digital assets, no, we have to map to the physical assets. That's the problem, this is physical to virtual mapping has to be done. That I told initially when I'm playing that Novus video also. And digital identity should be a real identity. This is the thing mapping we have to do. Now it is emerging, you know, the metaverse is emerging in the region of pandemic. Now you see, the pandemic situations, our online classes are all virtually happening. Now what you are feeling difficult in this particular current online classes? The problem we are facing is what? There is no collaboration. Virtual collaboration is that you may be sitting in an individual room and you may be watching classes. Many of them will not be watching the classes. You may not be watching the video. You may be doing some other task and you may be simply seems to be listening to the video. Or you switch on the video and you go to some other places or like that. No, something is happening. So now if whatever comes to real well collaboration can be there. Real collaboration will be there. The person from the other side can monitoring. Okay, that's going to happen. That's what will tell us physical to real mapping, physical to virtual mapping, and virtual to real physical mapping can be done easily. So that we can have some more collaboration. Now we can increase our collaboration by using the apps. So now you have to know the history of internet. Okay, history of internet. That's what Web 2.0 and Web 3.0. I hope the 100% students will know that. Currently, we are in the era of Web 3.0. Web 1.0 of HTML is created. Now, internet technologies, TCP, IP, protocol, everything is created during Web 2.0 era. Web 2.0 era mostly deal with the application, web applications, and user interaction, social media aging. Web 2.0. That's what that time, Orkut is there, Facebook is there. Then different set of social networking tools or certain social networking applications are there. And we are mostly dealing with Web 2.0, we deal with the interaction of application. That is what GUIF application, by using Ajax, single page application, you create JavaScript, HTML, all this technology you use for creating it. Now you see Web 3.0, it is moving to individual user. We are going to give personalized experience for the user. That's the another keyword you have to know here. In Web 3.0, you are going to give a personalized experience for the user. We are not going to deal with the social network. It's over. That era is over. Okay, Orkut is over. Then Facebook, no, that's also now going to an end. But now we are going to give a single user experience, individual users. Now we are going to give some different experience for them. How we are going to provide that experience is by using artificial intelligence, machine learning technologies, smart web application. We are not going to create online web application. We are going to create some smart web applications, okay? So that we can do some virtual reality with our web application, okay? We are going to implement augmented reality and virtual reality in a web application. Ordinary web applications we are going to implement. That will tell us what metaverse or Web 3.0 is a current app, okay? So now you have to know some four pillars of metaverse technology. That's holographic construction. Holographic simulation that I already explained in detail about that when I am explaining the videos. Again, I will explain. Virtual reality integration, virtual reality transformation. These are the four terms you have to know. Now, what is holographic construction? So, mapping people and object in the real world. Okay, we are creating a geometric model we are going to create. Okay, in the virtual world, we cannot create a physical model. It is difficult to simulate or difficult to create. So, what we are going to do is, we are going to create a physical model, a virtual model for people and object present in the real world. In the virtual world, we are going to create. So, that you see here, I think that more number of openings are there for civil engineers and mechanical engineers. So, the reason is, you may be doing some CAD design, star code design, you may be doing that. So, you see, each and every physical entities present in the real world, we have to do some model. Okay, geometric model, we have to do that. Then only we can display that in the virtual world, it is possible. Else it is not possible. So I think that enormous potential is there for mechanical engineering students, civil engineering students for creating some models. Okay, you are going to create the entire world in the virtual world you are going to create. Okay, currently, you see, again, two applications are there. Virtual VR house tool. Okay, now I heard that recently. You can purchase a land in the US. Now it is possible. You can purchase a land in the US and you can build a home in that particular land by using 3D printing. If 3D printing happens, no. You see, this is in a research actually. I think 3D printing is happening. So what you can do is virtually, you can see a land. You can browse a land and you can purchase the land. And you see, without a person, you can build a, you can create a house in that particular land by using 3D printing. It is possible. You understand? In virtual reality stores, it is possible. It's already it is there, no? Virtual reality store. So what you can do is you can browse some items present in the store. Virtually you can do that. By using augmented technology, virtual reality. So again, one more video is there. I'm not going to apply that, okay? Since there is time constraint, and we're not going to apply that. Okay. Then holographic simulation. Now what we have to do is we have done a geometric model we have created. Now we have to simulate that. If people are on the object in the real world, well, simulating the physical world dynamically in the real world. Okay, we have created a model, but what it has to do? It has to stimulate dynamically in the real time. Okay, so the model, the virtual model which we are going to create has to stimulate. That's what, in that movie, yes, in the physical model, it is going to do some action. So that action has to be done in the virtual model is also. Okay. So that is what, and then you see, people and objects in the virtual world follow the physical rules of our reality. So it has to be followed. Okay, physical rule has to be followed. That's what, if a person physically doing some activity, that has to be done by the virtual model also. That is there. Okay, so again, video, I am not going to tell. Then virtual reality integration. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to create a high precision 3D map of physical world to achieve accurate position realization virtual information overlay access. So we are going to create a 3D model. Okay. And we are going to break the boundaries between the virtual world and the physical world. So both will be unique. Okay. Physical world and the virtual world will be unique. And so that we are in such a that we are going to create a 3D model. Okay. And we are going to blend the information from the virtual world and the physical world. So we are going to combine the virtual world and physical world. So that's what we are going to create a virtual model. And we are going to make this model to act as a physical model. Okay, that's the thing you have to know clearly. Okay, so now virtual reality transformation. Now what we have to do is we have to do some transformation. That's what physical. We can tell us mapping to physical to virtual and virtual to physical. Something which is done in virtual, it has to map to the physical also. Something done in physical also should be mapped to the virtual. That's the thing you see here. I have given an example. On data center, right? So robot. Now currently, Alibaba Cloud or any cloud service provider, they know data centers. So they have to manage the service. Okay, it is difficult to human to manage with the human. Now you see, robot is never developed a robot so that it can automatically replace the hardware. Okay, hardware can be replaced by automatically. It will automatically assess the inventory. Okay. So it provides a complete solution of unattended inspection and data security for IT. So whole data center is automated. So whenever the hard disk failure occurs, human will not interfere in that. Robot will clear up to that. Even robot will identify that which part of the hard disk is going to fail out. Okay, that's another thing. Okay, that's what we are mapping physical to virtual world. We are going to map the physical world with the virtual world, and virtual world to the physical world. We are going to do that. So that's all about that's all about the pillars of virtual reality, that is holographic construction. We are going to create a 3D data model, physical and entity. Real virtual model we are going to create for the physical model. Okay, then holographic simulation, we are going to do 3D simulation for that. Then virtual, and we are going to integrate virtual reality and virtual transformation we are going to do with that model. Okay, that's the thing. Now we are going to see what are the metaverse technology available in Alibaba Cloud. Now if you are adopting Alibaba Cloud, myself I am working as Alibaba Cloud MVP. So I am going to explain how if you are adopting Alibaba Cloud, so Alibaba Cloud as a cloud service provider. So what are the different products or what are different technologies available for creating metaverse application by leveraging Alibaba Cloud? We are going to see. Now you see remote rendering. Okay, remote rendering is what? We have to display the real, display the physical world in the real world. We have to do some rendering. It should be there. Huh? Now most probably in metaverse, now rendering will be done not in the screen actually. We have seen that video. It will be done in the open space. Okay. So for doing the rendering, you see, you have to convert the physical world to the real world. You have to do that. For that, that process will tell us rendering. We cannot. If you are using ordinary computer for that, it will take days. So we have to do some high computing performance technology. We have to utilize high performance computing technology that has to be utilized for that. So Alibaba Cloud is going to support that. Okay, Alibaba Cloud is going to support high performance computing technology. If you want to enter the physical world to the real world, we need some high performance computing technologies required. It is supported by Alibaba Cloud products such as Elastic Compute Service. It's a virtual machine we utilize normally. Elastic High Performance Computing, Elastic Desktop Service, Elastic GPU Service, and Five Storage Service. Okay, Five Storage Network Attached Storage Service. And I can explain each and every service as I am MVP in Alibaba Cloud for half an hour or 1 hour, but I'm not going to do that since my time is constrained. So I have another meeting at 10:15. Okay. So now you see data analytics and AI. So without that, now you see Web 3.0. No, without data analytics and AI, we cannot tell the technology. There is no technology in Web 3.0. No? Nowadays, all the technologies, all the scenarios or all the parts. No, we are using data analytics and AI. Okay. Now, what are the scenarios we can utilize? Is computer vision, machine learning, natural language processing, and intelligent speech recognition. For this scenarios, we can use data analytics and AI in metaverse. Now you see what are the products utilized for this purpose. If you want to create some applications related to metaverse and related to data analytics and AI, you have to utilize these products: Max Compute, DataV, Apsara DB for Polar DB. It is a database for storing 100 GB of data can store in Apsara DB for Polar DB. It's a proprietary product of Alibaba Cloud. And DataWorks, it is a scheduling tool which is used for creating some models. And machine learning platform for SPI2. Okay, it's visual modeling can be done. Visually, we can model some algorithms by using machine learning for AI or platform for AI. Normally, we tell us SPI2. So this is the data analytics and AI tools which we can utilize for creating metaverse application with Alibaba Cloud. So now going to internet of things. Nowadays, you see IoT is getting some momentum. So some IoT edge devices will be there. It will be deployed. Now you can see that in your college itself, some IoT devices will be there. It will fetch the data from the environment, like you send frequently, it will send it to the server. And based on that, we can get some insights of that particular data. We can do that. So Alibaba Cloud IoT solutions for reliable wireless connectivity and signal transmission service for virtual reality integration of the device. So you see here, we have to integrate this. We have to display the virtual reality. We have to do that. We have to display that. So we need some IoT devices for that. So some chips or devices we need so that we can display that in the open world. It is possible. Yes, it is not possible. That's provided by IoT. So various products used are. Now all of you please take a note on this product. Some products maybe in the pieces, not some products. I have asked some products over there. Okay, so you have to answer for that. So IoT platform, it is a product. It is a product through which we can link the IoT device with the Alibaba Cloud platform. So each and every IoT device is present now. It will send the data to the centralized server. Okay, centralized server we have to purchase. If you purchase an IoT platform service, centralized servers server will be provided for us, so that no, all the data should be sent to the server and we can get some insight on that data. Then IoT Edge, you know, yeah, linked, this is a new product which is released in Alibaba Cloud. Now we can provide some edge process, edge computing nodes for processing the data and getting the insight, so that no, data will not be processed in the centralized server, the remote server. So data is processed in the edge servers, okay, edge computing nodes. So that's we tell us link IoT edge. So nowadays, no, similar to cloud computing, edge computing is getting some momentum. Okay. So in actually, what is happening in edge computing is, so the data is not processed in the remote server. The edge server is going to be processed. Okay, that's the thing we tell us edge computing. So that's link IoT edge. So we are going to have some IoT devices in the edge node, and we are going to process the data. The edge node and the insights of this particular data will be stored in the centralized server. Okay. So now blockchain. I hope everyone will be knowing about blockchain technology. It is another important technology which is used in metaverse. And Alibaba Cloud is also going to provide this kind of service in this kind of blockchain technology by using a service termed as blockchain as a service. BaaS. We tell us BaaS. Well, it will provide set of services. Okay, for you for creating blockchain application. You see, what is the use of blockchain? It ensures traceability and non-temporable database. We can create non-temporable database. Database, no, which is created, is not temporal, which is not, it is unable to temper the database. So that, no, all the details, transaction you have made, whatever thing you are done with the application, it will be there in the top. It will be saved as a block, and it cannot be tempered. Untempered data, no, data cannot be untempered. That's the thing you know about blockchain. Okay. Now you see. So now moving to global network solutions. So I already mentioned that if you are using remote runtime technologies we are going to utilize. So we need the fast networking technologies. No, that's a thing. No, we are nowadays we are going to 5G network. Yes. So we are going to render some models. Virtual physical model is rendered as a virtual model. And it is in the open space, so we have to need a high bandwidth network should be there. So some networking products are there which are provided by Alibaba Cloud. So you can utilize that when you are going to create some metaverse applications. So these are the products you see: cloud enterprise network, smart access gateway, enterprise connect, VPN gateway. So if you want to have a better connectivity, okay, if you want to connect with the connect your IoT devices or any applications, augmented reality or virtual reality devices with the network, you can use this kind of products as cloud enterprise network, smart access gateway, enterprise connect, and virtual private gateway. You can utilize container service. Nowadays, you see, when speaking about 10 to 15 years back or 10 years back, we will be deploying our application. Or we will purchase a server. We will purchase a physical server, and we will install all the products in that, you know, all the software structure for running our application in that particular server. Then what will be doing? We will deploy our application over there. Now you see later, I am thinking about after that physical, you know, virtual machines thing. You will have a virtual machine or get a machine. You will install a high process software over that. And in that, no, what you will do? You will install multiple OSs, and then in that OS, no, you will install the software. Now you see what we are going to do is we are going to create a container. Okay, we are going to create a container by using Docker. In a single virtual machine, we can create multiple containers and we can host multiple applications also. That means us in Alibaba Cloud, no, we extend that Alibaba Cloud container service for Kubernetes. In short, we will tell us ACK, Alibaba Cloud Container Service for Kubernetes. So if you want to create a container application, if you want to orchestrate or manage the container application, we will go for Alibaba Cloud Container Service for Kubernetes. So we are not going to create an application by using ordinary physical or virtual servers. We are not going to utilize it. This is the latest technology for creating our application. Here comes now, I think, the role of computer engineers. Okay, computer engineers. Till what we learn now, it is a role of mechanical engineers or civil engineers. I think that, no, When I'm talking to my friend, he told that more number of openings here for mechanical engineers, civil engineers, I think there was no only small role is going to be played by our computer engineers. So you see, this is the role, no? Create an application, you are going to create some application, whatever applications that may be done by the computer engineers, okay, software engineers or developers. And once application is created, how we are going to deploy the application, that is very, very important. So nowadays, knowing again, microservices we are going to use. Microservices, we know, we are going to deploy our application in a container, separate container we are going to deploy our applications. So we are going to use Alibaba. If you are going to use Metaverse with Alibaba Cloud, you are going to use Alibaba Cloud Container Service for Kubernetes. So it provides rich scheduling, orchestration, deployment, and publishing capability for microservices. Okay, microservices application we are going to create. So monolithic application is there. That's 10 years back. Now, what are the applications we are creating now? We will tell that as monolithic application. Now it is microservices. We are going to deploy the application in a separate container. Okay, and it's highly available, highly scalable, low cost, automated, continuous integration, continuous delivery is there, and help users build Metaverse application quickly. So we can create Metaverse application quickly by using Alibaba Cloud Container Service for Kubernetes. We are using Alibaba Cloud. And you see, Alibaba Cloud support three types of ACK clusters. Alibaba Cloud Container Service for Kubernetes clusters. So dedicated Kubernetes, managed Kubernetes, and serverless Kubernetes. Now what is dedicated Kubernetes? So in dedicated Kubernetes, you have to create a master node and worker node. Okay, you have to know that in Kubernetes, master node will be there, worker node will be there. Okay. So now managed Kubernetes, we need to create and manage worker node. Master node will be created by the Alibaba Cloud Container Service for Kubernetes. Serverless Kubernetes, both master node and worker node will be created by Alibaba Cloud. We did not want to create that. Okay, that's related to the process. Okay, related to the process. Dedicated Kubernetes, we have to create both master node and worker node. Managed Kubernetes, master node will be created by Alibaba Cloud, and worker node has to be created by us. Serverless Kubernetes, both will be created by Alibaba Cloud. We did not want to do that. Dynamically create an application. Okay, that's another advantage of serverless Kubernetes. Okay, so we can create a container creating worker node and master node, and we can deploy the application by single click. We can deploy some application. Okay, so you see here you think this container we are going to utilize for deploying the application. Okay, you created something that you have created a Metaverse application. Okay, you have created a Metaverse application. Now what you have to do is you have to deploy your application. But where you have to deploy? You have to deploy in the server. Yes, then only you can utilize that. This is a server application. No? So for deployment, you can utilize which technology? Alibaba Cloud Container Service for Kubernetes. That's container technology you can utilize for deploying your application. Okay, so that's all. I think this is a recap what we learned in 1 hour. So I think that I guess you got a small spark on you. So what is Metaverse? I didn't know more things. So I thought of covering more about this blockchain and things, but it's not possible. Okay, anyway, we learned about introduction to cloud. What is cloud? Advantages of cloud, why the organization is moving from the traditional IDC to the cloud environment. We learned about scalability is an important advantage of Alibaba Cloud or any cloud service provider. So we can scale dynamically and horizontally. It is possible. Dynamically we can scale, horizontally and vertically it is possible. Okay. Now four pillars are holographic construction. Okay. Holographic simulation, what we are going to do is we are going to map the object and people in the real world to the virtual world, or in the physical world to the virtual world. That we are going to do in construction and simulation. Construction, we are going to create a geometric model, and simulation, we are going to simulate that. Okay. Then we are going to integrate the virtual reality with the virtual reality and virtual transformation we are going to. Okay. That's what in transformation, we are going to map virtual physical world to the real world and real world to the physical world. Next, objects and people present in the real world, we are going to map to the physical world, real world in the virtual world, and again vice versa, virtual world to the real world. So if real world, no, you can tell us real world or physical world also. Okay, as you know, should not confuse with the terms. Okay, now how we can implement Metaverse in Alibaba Cloud? That's remote rendering. We are going to use some product, elastic compute service, ECS, Okay, then Elastic Desktop Service, then some of the services are there we are going to utilize for remote rendering. Then data analytics and AI we are going to utilize. Platform for AI is another tool. Max Computing is another tool. Then PolarDB is another tool. These are the various products or tools which we are going to utilize in Alibaba Cloud. Then blockchain as a service is another technology we are going to use. And global network solution. We have to provide for remote rendering. We have to provide some good network solutions. So for that, no, some products are like cloud enterprise network is there. Then virtual private network is there. Few other network technologies are there that you have to offer. And finally, we have learned about how to deploy our application. We think that we have created an application, okay, the server application for metaverse. Now you have to deploy that. If you have to not deploy that, the end user cannot utilize that application. Yes. So for deploying that application, we are going for Alibaba Cloud Container Service. Okay. So I hope you understand this. Now this is the thing. Now you see four pillars. Here the major role is going to be played by what? It's going to be played by civil and mechanical engineers. So that's first of the thing. No remote rendering. These are the things now which is going to be played by computer science or data analyst or data scientist or developer or a software engineer is going to do this work. So that's all. I hope that you understand about metaverse. Now we are going to announce the key takeaways. So now I will explain how to download the certificate. So we are going to, as multi-cloud is going to host this program for your college. So we are going to provide a level 1 certificate for you. And from Alibaba Cloud, you are going to get Alibaba Cloud Cloud certifications from Alibaba Cloud. So now I will explain how to download the certificate. Okay. So now you have to copy this URL. Okay. This is the URL. I hope that already you have done a registration for this. So I will share this in the chat. Okay. This is a URL. Just click this URL. Now you will be taken to the private dashboard. Okay, you will be taken to the private dashboard. So now this is I already explained about this. The industrial revolution. We are mostly focusing on nano systems or nano courses. So we are going to make the persons ready for the 5th industrial revolution. You can see some of the courses over here. So now you can enroll in this course. Already I have logged in with this username and password. So now just you click client certificates. Now you click next. Now you provide this code. Okay, 2BPPI2. This is the code you have to provide over there. Now I will share that in the chat. This is a speaker code you have to provide over there. Okay, your certificate address is taken and certificate name will be sent to your mail ID. Okay. Now, how to download certificate, if you can see that. So to download the certificate from Alibaba Cloud, just you click take this. So now you have to provide a username and password of Alibaba Cloud. Okay. So now we'll be taken to the now we enter the just you click enter the test. In my case, no, I have already taken the test. So see, you are already passed this test. Go to the user center to collect the test. Now we submit it. I got my certificate over here. Okay. Was great. Successfully completed multiple for training on Alibaba Pro. Metal Alibaba Pro. Okay. Now we can showcase this certificate in LinkedIn or any other social media platforms. Okay. So this is the thing. How to download the certificate? Now you are going to get two certificates for this particular system. One certificate from Alibaba Cloud after completing the quizzes, and another certificate from MultiCloud for you. It is a level one certificate, and you have to provide this as a speaker board. Okay. So now I think this is a certificate you are going to get from Alibaba Cloud after completing the quizzes. Okay, 15 quizzes are there. It is a simple quizzes now. What I just covered in this particular session, the questions you can ask in the question. Okay. Now that's all for the session. Any doubts, any Q&A sessions, we can
thank you, Gavaskar.